When you're learning or using a new language, it's important to understand what the features are that the language offers and whether there's any overhead associated with those features. This gets particularly interesting in Kotlin because it offers features that are not in the Java programming language, even though it compiles down to the bytecode of that other language. So how does that work? And is there overhead associated with any of those features? And if there is there anything that we can do about that? That's why I'm here today. I'm going to talk about enums and switch statements and about some of the non-obvious overhead associated with those and about how you can use the Android R8 compiler to optimize your app and reduce that overhead. First, I want to talk about D8 and R8. In fact, I want to talk about three compilers. There's actually three compilers that kick in for the Kotlin code that you write for your Android applications. First of all, the Kotlin compiler runs and converts your Kotlin code into bytecode for the Java programming language. It just translates it along the way, which is great, except we don't run that bytecode on Android devices. Instead, we run something called DEX, which stands for Dalvik Executable. Dalvik was the name of the original runtime on Android. Now the runtime is called ART for Android runtime. Details, don't worry about it. It's called DEX code, right? So D8 comes in, the second compiler, and it translates from that Java programming language bytecode into DEX code. And at that point, you could run your program. Or you could optionally use a third compiler called R8, which is used for optimizing and shrinking your application, basically a replacement for ProGuard. So since it's not enabled by default, if you want to use this, which you may for some of the optimizations we're going to talk about, you need to enable it. If you go to your build.gradle file for your application, and you can set minify enabled to true, and that will force R8 to run at the end of all that other compilation to make sure that you get your shrunk and optimized app. Now, let's talk about enums. So I'm going to talk about a feature and overhead that is essentially true whether you're writing in Java code or Kotlin code. But it's interesting what we can do about some of that overhead once we introduce R8 into the mix. So enums by themselves don't have any overhead that is non-obvious. If you're using an enum in Kotlin, then that's going to translate to an enum in the Java programming language. Same kind of thing. Not a big deal, right? The trick comes if you use switch statements. So first of all, let's take a look at some enum code. So we've declared this enum code for this blend mode. We have four values there. It doesn't really matter what they are. It's just an example. And for each one of those, we're going to then enter the switch statement or a when statement in Kotlin. And based on the value of the enum, we're going to execute some more code. We're going to call another function, right? Pretty straightforward. Now, if you take a look at what it is actually compiled down to in the JVM bytecode, it looks something like this, right? So instead of just doing a switch on the value, it actually calls into this array. Where did that array come from? And the array is stashed in this generated class file. Where did that class file come from, right? So what is going on here? It turns out that for binary compatibility reasons, the code can't simply switch on the value, on the ordinal value of the enum, because that could break. Right, so you could have a library that has an enum, and if you change the order of those items in the enum, then you could break somebody's application, even though like actually it looked the same in the code, they were just in different order, but it was the implementation detail of the ordering that caused the breakage. So instead, they take the ordinal value and they map it to another value, and then no matter what you do with those enums, code that is built with that library will still run. So all of that's great, but it does mean that something is going to get generated on your behalf. So if we look at the generated code, it looks something like this. So there's that class that gets generated, and inside of that is an array where we're going to do the mappings, and then some static code which actually performs the mapping operation. So interestingly, we have one single when statement in there, or the switch statement that we saw earlier. If we had another when statement somewhere else in the code, we would generate another array, and another array, and another array. So all of these aren't that big a deal, but it does mean that unbeknownst to you, a class is being generated on your behalf, and then some number of arrays inside of that class, just taking more time at class loading time and instantiating all these things and loading up when your application is ready to go. So is there something that we could do about it, that? Well, it turns out there is. If we use R8, it's actually smart enough to do the right thing here. So R8 is an interesting optimizer. It can see everything in your application. It sees all the code, whether it's the code that you wrote or the library code that you're building against, and it can make decisions about optimizations to know that, for example, in this situation, it can avoid that overhead. It does not need that mapping information because it knows that you are only going to use these enums in this certain way, and so it can actually just call into the ordinal value instead, and it avoids having to create the class, avoids having to create the array, and just creates the optimal code that you want to begin with. So check out R8, check out Kotlin, and enjoy writing better Android applications with Kotlin. If you like this video, go ahead and like and share it, and also subscribe to the Android Developers channel. Thanks.